Penguin Random House Audio presents The Power of Zero, revised and updated. How to Get to the 0% Tax Bracket and Transform Your Retirement by David McKnight. Read for you by Marc Cashman. Foreword. Taxes will be increasing. This book is a wake-up call to reality. For the past 20 years, I have been warning both consumers and advisors that the writing is on the wall, and the day of reckoning is upon us. This is not a prediction, but a result of plain arithmetic. Our government will soon need huge cash infusions to meet its commitments, and it will have no choice but to raise taxes on those of us who have worked hard, sacrificed, saved, and played by the rules. We were told to put money away for retirement in tax-deferred accounts, like 401ks and IRAs, and many of us did. Those who saved the most diligently, though, will soon realize that a substantial chunk of those tax-deferred retirement savings are sitting ducks for a revenue-hungry Uncle Sam. In fact, as your 401k or IRA funds grow, so does the government share, since it is a partner on your savings. But unlike a traditional business partner, Uncle Sam can increase his partnership percentage of your tax-deferred savings whenever he needs more money. And that day is coming soon. The question is then, are you prepared? You can be, but unfortunately, for most people, the answer is no, because they believe that there is no way this can happen to them. But it can, and it will. We have had federal income tax rates exceeding 90%. In fact, from 1936 to 1981, the top federal income tax rate has never gone below 70%. Higher taxes mean less money for your retirement years. Even if you think you are prepared with a plan, it is unlikely that you are. In fact, in most cases I see, the kind of planning you need to do now to avoid the oncoming tax disaster train is not being done. If you have to wonder if you have a plan to reduce your income taxes now and in the future, then you do not have a plan. If you don't have a plan, you will end up with what I call the government plan. As you can imagine, that is not the plan that is best for you. The plan that you need must be implemented by you and be done as soon as possible before the tax train wreck arrives. You need to create a plan to move your tax-deferred funds from accounts that are forever being taxed to accounts that are never taxed. Your best defense is offense, to build tax-free savings. The good news is that right now we are in the lowest tax rates in recent history. Now is the time to strike in order to create tax-free income for your retirement years and beyond. Even your loved ones can benefit from the planning you do now. The tax code actually includes several tax moves you can make to create tax-free retirement income, but few people take advantage of them. For example, Roth IRAs and life insurance alone can help you and your family end up with more money than you have now, and with more of it tax-free. There will never be a more cost-effective time to leverage your current assets into tax-free assets. As you move your tax-deferred funds to tax-free territory, you reduce the impact of future tax hikes on your retirement savings. In this book, David McKnight, who, like me, also loves tax-free, provides you with a roadmap of how to get to the 0% tax bracket, virtually eliminating the tax risk, which, if not addressed, will easily consume a solid portion of your retirement savings. It's time to face reality. Taxes will increase, and tax-deferred accounts like 401ks and IRAs are the low-hanging fruit waiting to be picked by Uncle Sam. Follow the steps in this book, and you'll keep your hard-earned retirement savings out of Uncle Sam's reach. I love tax-free, and you will too. Tax-free is always better. Pay less and keep more. Ed Slott, CPA, author and founder of IRAHelp.com and theslotreport.com. Founder, Ed Slott's Elite IRA Advisor Group, August 12, 2013. One, a gathering storm. Delight in smooth-sounding platitudes, refusal to face unpleasant facts, desire for popularity and electoral success, irrespective of the vital interests of the state. Winston Churchill, The Gathering Storm. On January 11, 2011, a CPA named David M. Walker appeared on national radio and made a grim prognostication. Based on the current fiscal path, future tax rates will have to double, or our country could go bankrupt. He then challenged the national listening audience to come up with a four-letter word that would explain why. The calls came pouring in. Debt came one answer. Wars came another. Kids came the next. After a few more wayward guesses, David Walker finally revealed the answer. It's math. Who is David Walker, and what does math have to do with the future of our country? For an 11-year period, starting in 1998, David Walker served as the Comptroller General of the United States and as the head of the Government Accountability Office. In short, he was the CPA of the USA and the nation's chief auditor. Having performed in that capacity during both the Clinton and Bush administrations, he knows more about our country's fiscal state than perhaps anyone else on the planet. Since his resignation in 2008, Walker has been crisscrossing the country, raising the warning cry, and discussing sensible solutions with anyone who will listen. To understand the urgency behind David Walker's mission, you need look no further than the mathematical realities facing Social Security. The Social Security Act was passed into law in 1935 as the linchpin of Roosevelt's New Deal with America. When it was first implemented, the math behind it, based on expected birth rates and life expectancies, ensured its financial viability into perpetuity. There were an astounding 42 workers putting money into Social Security for every one person who took money out. Ironically, the official retirement age at that time was 65, well beyond the then average life expectancy of only 62. The program's administrators didn't even anticipate that the average American would live long enough to ever draw on Social Security. If you did make it to 65, you drew on Social Security for only a few years until you died. You see, Social Security was never intended to be a retirement program. It was merely insurance against living too long. But then, something happened that would change Social Security forever. Soldiers came home from World War II and started to do something at a rate at which they'd never done before. They started making babies. Great, you may be thinking. More babies equals more workers, which mean more contributions to the Social Security program. That would be true if these baby boomers had decided to have nearly as many children as their parents did. But they didn't. They had 32 million fewer children. And this is where the math to which David Walker refers catches up with us. Today, there are no longer 42 people contributing to Social Security for every one person who takes money out of the program. The ratio has fallen to 3-1. And in another 10 years, it's going to be closer to 2-1. Compounding the problem, Americans can now draw Social Security as early as 62, and, due to advancements in science and medical technology, retirees are living longer than ever. The reality is, if you start drawing on Social Security at 62, you'll keep drawing it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.